More than 5,700 Coloradans and 471,000 Americans have died from the coronavirus. These are more than just numbers, they're people. A new survey finds one in three Americans knows someone who has died. Those are mothers, fathers, daughters, and sons whose memories won't be forgotten. And now a local couple is offering a new resource for people to share their grief. Denver 7's Micah Smith joins us with a look at that.
Molly, every day we report the latest information on the vaccine and what our state is doing to stop the spread of COVID-19. But for thousands of Coloradans who have lost someone to COVID-19, medical breakthroughs are too late. Their loved ones are gone, but we have not forgotten them. I talked to Shay and Langston Jacobs, a married couple who about 3 years ago experienced the loss of Langston's mother, their niece, and their son, all within a six-month time frame. They immediately decided they didn't want to run away from that feeling of loss, but wanted to find help. But Shay Jacobs says resources, especially for African Americans, were scarce. She says even a list of grief resources she received from the hospital was unhelpful.
It may have organizations that are no longer in existence. The information may not be updated. And it broke my heart that it is on the responsibility of the grievers, right, to try to find help.
So Shay and Langston Jacobs created Adam's Purpose, named after their son who passed away. Their organization connects people with support groups, counselors, and a number of other resources to help them get through the grieving process.
It gets better. It may seem like everything, the lights have been turned off. It may feel like you've been unplugged and there's no more power source. But to hang on in there, because it does get better.
Adam's Purpose is hosting a virtual grief conference March 5th and 6th. It is free and open to the public. We have more information on our website. Shay and Langston say their goal is to provide help, hope, and healing to anyone who is grieving right now. Molly.
And you hear those numbers, they are just so heartbreaking. Thank you, Micah.